hectic. Let's start the recording. Yeah, so the last 2 weeks have been super hectic. I definitely wanted to stream more than never in the last 2 weeks. But I just either didn't have time, and this weekend's a 3 day weekend, so I wanted to stream like at least twice this weekend, but Saturday I was busy as hell. Yesterday I was busy as hell. Strange how I have more time, yet somehow end up more busy in that time. So, anyway, I am going to be playing Forza Horizon 2, trying to get some of the Quest 100% stuff. Maybe later doing Undertale. I'm not sure. It really depends on how I feel later on, whether I want to switch to Undertale, whether I want to switch to a different game, or whether I'm just gonna keep playing Forza the entire time. But let's get into the game. I think the webcam's positioned fine. We'll find out. I'm in. Oh, what was this again? Ford
You
Fiesta.
have arrived at your destination.
For no reason other than the fact that there's an achievement for it, to win an event in the 81 Ford Fiesta. That's basically the only, like, basically the next, basically the rest of the day and the next, like, few tournaments especially, it's going to basically be me driving cars that have achievements tied to them. Because there's a few of those achievements where it's like, oh, well, you gotta drive this car and win an event in this car, win an event in this car. It's a lot easier to do it here than to try to do it multiplayer, because there's no way I'm gonna win events in multiplayer. Because I'm me. The chance of me winning anything in multiplayer is pretty much non-existent. So, let's try to just win the events here and then hope for the best. There's also a bunch for the Porsche DLC. There's a bunch of ones where it's like, win 4 events in this car. It's like, screw you, game. Why are you having me win all those events in one car? I mean, to be fair, there's 4 events per tournament, so it's basically, I could just start a tournament and make sure I missed a checkpoint. God damn it. That's a fitting way to start everything. That's a fitting way to start everything. Missing a checkpoint. Great. I may do. I probably will do some other games later, because I don't know how long I plan to stream. But again, it's basically a day off. I don't have anything really to do today, so I can stream basically as long as I want. And I pretty much can guarantee that I probably won't. I love how I said, I can guarantee that I probably, like, those are two completely conflicting words, Eric. Get your English right. But I can probably, I can pretty much guarantee, as I do the exact same thing. I realize my mistake now. The checkpoint's on the other side of that pillar. But I'm pretty sure that later on I'm gonna be like, you know what, I don't feel like playing this anymore. I don't feel like doing this, so I'll probably switch to something else. What I switch to, I'm not sure. It's mostly a matter of, do I want to switch to PC? And if I switch to PC, it'll probably be Undertale, unless I feel like doing Overwatch, which I'm not huge on multiplayer games in general, so I probably wouldn't want to do that on stream. Or at least multiplayer, like shooters and stuff. Unless there's like friends online that are playing it, I really don't think I want to try that. But if I switch over to PC, it'll probably be Undertale. If I stick with this, there's a few games that I can try to play. I have Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2 downloaded, but I still haven't played it, so maybe I'll start that. You know, see how that is. Because I've seen gameplay, so I know kind of what to expect, but I've never played it myself, so. Or I could go into, like, Rare Replay and do some of the achievements for those, like Jetpack Refueled. Jetpack Refueled, I have a lot of achievements to get in that. We'll see. There's so many possibilities. and by so many possibilities, I mean like the three that I'll actually choose. There's a lot of possibilities, but there's only like three that, let's be honest, that I'll actually fully consider. Because I could play Halo. I'm not going to do that. That's a possibility, but that's not going to happen. I still have not launched that yet. Got my Xbox with Halo Master Chief Collection. I've not started up once. I downloaded it, but then have not started it up. There's actually a lot of games, though. I mean, most of them, though, were games with gold. So there's a lot of, like, free games I got for free that I just haven't started up because they either just don't appeal to me or I've had just so many other games that I haven't gotten around to the other games. Okay, oh, it's second lap. Never mind. I was going to say, I better pass him so I can win this event and get that achievement. So that I don't have to worry about it for the rest of the thing, but it's the second lap. We're good. We can do this. We got this. I may do multiplayer in this later, but I kind of want to make single player progress because there's a lot of single player progress that needs to be made. I have, what, 25 events? I have 25 events, I think it is. And there's 25 championships I have. And there's 168 total. So yeah. This is basically going to be one of those games that's like, I'll do it once in a while, you know, get some progress here. I may do it off stream too, because it's basically just going to be this. Me racing, crashing into things 50 million times, and potentially winning races at some point. But it'll be one of those games that's just kind of like there. Like, oh, I don't feel like if I have another series going on, it's like, oh, I don't feel like doing this. Oh, I can do Forza. And then just come back and do this. Although I better get through it and get those multiplayer achievements before it gets to that point where everyone stops playing multiplayer. I tried playing online for Need for Speed Hot Pursuit on Xbox 360. Just because I was like, oh, well, I was doing a video. I was like, oh, well, I'll try multiplayer. Yeah, no one plays multiplayer, apparently, anymore. Which I shouldn't be surprised, because the game's from, like, 2010, I think it was. Or 2009, whatever. And there have been a ton of Need for Speed games, not to mention just racing games in general.
Wow.
Oh!
Nice work, mate. You just earned yourself a silver wristband.
I didn't realize I was that close to the silver. Cool. I don't get an achievement for that, but that means I'm closer to the gold. And yes, I will do that. I need to do the rival races too, because I don't want to have a bunch of them left over at the end. I looked at... I did like the calculations. I mean, it wasn't hard calculations. It was pretty much nothing, but I need to make... Because I need to make 1 million total in rival races to be able to get the achievement. With the amount of tournaments I have left, not even amount of races, just the amount of tournaments I have left, if I get 5,000 credits from Rivals each tournament, a little over 5,000, it's like 5,100 and something, but if I get a little over 5,000 for each tournament from Rivals, I'm good. Like, I don't have to, basically I just have to do one race, because I get, like, if I beat them, I get that 2,000 that it says was up for grabs, and then get a bunch of bonus ones. It's like, oh, you get 2,000, but you also get another 8,000 pile on top of it because reasons. Like, all right, cool, thanks. I'm not complaining. And eventually it's going to get to a point where I just have to get, like, you know, maybe, like, 3,000, if that. I could basically do one lap, not win, and still get enough credits, because you get credits whether or not you beat your rival or not, which is great. Like, I could stop it right now and I will get credits. I just don't think, because I only tried one lap, I won't get enough credits. I want to at least try to beat. I found out the lap races are actually much better for getting credits, too. It seems like the bonus credits you get are a lot more with lap races than they are for sprint races. So what I'm going to try to do, I'm going to do 3 laps or until I beat this guy. Or until I beat this ghost. And then I'll be done. Because by then I should have 5,000 credits. After 3 laps, or if I beat him and get that 2,000 and then pile on another whatever on top of it, I should be able to do it, which I might do this lap, unless I screw it up majorly. It's also easy because I have a slow car. I have a slower car. And the Rivals, it gives you scale to whatever your best lap was, so once I got a good lap going, and I have no cars around me, it's really not that difficult. Cool, I won. No, do not continue lapping. Because that is the most boring. Oh! Awesome! That counted as winning an event. That's awesome. See, I got, like, difficulty insists, fine, whatever, but I got 7,286 for winning, despite the fact that it said I would get 2,000 for winning. I got almost 2 tournaments worth of credits right there. In one rival race. No. I don't want to fight Flipper Sphere. Oh, I earned... I can spin, that's right. I forgot spins are a thing. I could also, at some point... I don't want to do tournaments because I'm doing it for series, doing it for YouTube. I don't want to do tournaments in Storm Island, but I could go and do... You know, get all the... Get all of the... things. The things and the stuff. The bonus boards, the roads, and the third thing. I could do the bucket list items. I could do all those. Because those I'm not doing for the series, but I just don't want to do any tournaments on Storm Island until after I finish that. And then I'll probably... What I'll probably end up doing is I'll finish that probably well before I finish this. Like, I'll finish that well before I get that far in Storm Island. Or, the main game, before I get enough tournaments in the main game. So what I'll probably do is I'll probably be... Finish Storm Island, finish the series, then start doing the Storm Island 100% in this, and then go back to the main game. Just as like a break. Or I might just leave it there as like, oh hey, I want a break from the main game, I can go do Storm Island now rather than doing it right away. Because I definitely know I'll need a break from the main game single player with 168 freaking tournaments. It's not like, oh, there's 168, but I don't need all of them for the achievement. I only need like a certain amount. No, there's an achievement for 100. I almost said 1,000. If there were 1,000 tournaments, I would not be doing this 100%. But there's 100 tournament achievement, you know, to win 100 championships. Then there's an achievement for winning all 168. So it's not a short run to get all the achievements in this game. If you're the kind, see, luckily I'm not the kind that looks for like easy achievements and just tries to get as many as possible. I'm not one of the people that's going for gamer score. I'm just going for, hey, I like this game, I want to finish it 100%. Otherwise, there's zero chance that I would do this game as a 100% run, because it's just, I am not doing good right now. I'm also still in highly skilled because I switched back to it for Storm Island because it was getting too easy. Although the last episode wasn't easy. Last episode that I recorded, at least. God, it is freaking hot in here. See, we have central air and stuff in our apartment. Like, we have a unit basically dedicated to our apartment. But I feel like the people that put it in originally didn't measure the square footage of the apartment and didn't get one that's supposed to cover that square footage. They were just like, they chose one and they're like, eh, it's close enough. Is this good? Yeah, sure, why not? Because if it gets anywhere above like 80 outside, it just does not cool down at all. Like, if it gets anywhere above 80, it's like, it can cool the air outside to like, it can cool in here to like maybe 5-6 degrees below what it is outside, which when it's like 85 outside, that's still 80 degrees in the apartment. Not to mention our air conditioner was broken for a day. Basically, the fan wasn't working, so it wasn't circulating any air. Called the emergency maintenance, they're like, oh, well, it's not an emergency, it's a luxury, despite the fact that it was freaking, like, almost 90 degrees outside and pretty much almost that in here, too. It's like, oh, it's a luxury. They're not supposed to come out unless elderly or sick. It's like, last time I checked, still die of heat stroke if you're not elderly or sick. But whatever. Then he comes out to check it, and it works fine. It's just completely fine. Basically, I guess having it off overnight was like enough for it to say, oh wait, I'm supposed to actually run. So when we turned it on, it worked fine. I mean, worked fine being relative to, you know, the fact that it still is like, we have it at 74 set to, and it's still like 78 in here, because God forbid it's slightly too hot outside. The air conditioner's like, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to condition air. Okay, so I'm not doing great, clearly. I probably should have chosen, even though I did need the achievement in this, I should probably choose a different car. I don't know if I have another car this race type. Because this is what, retro hot hatch. I don't know if I have another car that I can use. I mean, I have plenty of cars, but I don't know if any of them are, like, ready to be used. Because that one's there, but it's not actually upgraded. It's just exists. The Volkswagen Rabbit? I could use that. It's the fastest one I have. God damn it. Just random fireworks in the background. Why? Why are there just random... They just set off fireworks every night at the Ryzen Festival for no reason. It's gotta get expensive. I'm sure fireworks aren't cheap. Like, the kind that you shoot up in the air, at least. Not cheap, I'm sure. I don't know from experience, so I could be completely wrong, but I'm sure they're not cheap. And they're doing it every night. So, okay, I just want to at least finish this tournament in first. I want to finish all tournaments in first, really. But I definitely want to finish this one, because I keep ending up in, like, ninth place and then having to catch up. Like, this car sucks at starting. The acceleration's just god-awful in this car. I do not know why I'm driving this. I need the achievement. But besides that, I don't know why I'm driving this. I feel like I should have gone with a D-class car. Might have, you know, one of the ones that's right on the Edge of D-Class, even though they have no upgrades, it might... Oh, never mind. Actually, this is actually really good, because the first place person, I don't remember their name, aren't in the top three, so that's actually very good. Very good for me. This is a three-lap race. I don't think I've ever seen a lap race, like a circuit race, use that road, like the hairpin turns. Some sprint races have, some, you know, point-to-point races have, but I don't think any with laps have used that yet, that I've done. I mean, I have only done 25 championships, so... It's one of those where it's like, every time I want to play this, you know, 100% completion sounds like a good idea, and then it's like, oh, I still have 143 tournaments to go. God damn it. Like, I still need 5 just to get to the second Horizon finale. And I don't know what the second Horizon finale is. I don't know if it's a completely different race, or if it's the same race, just again. Like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what it is. We'll see, I guess. But this race actually really helps, because I don't see first place anywhere behind me. I don't see the first place person anywhere behind me, so... Let's hope for the best. Let's hope for the best. And by the best, I don't mean my best. I hope for better than my best. Because my best sucks. Doesn't matter what game it is, my best sucks. Oh no. Almost ran into a wall. Again. My best sucks. I'm surprised that I haven't crashed like at all this race. Especially with like the tight turns and hairpin turns. I guarantee if I upgraded this car to like B class, we're going so much faster, I would not be doing near as well. Gotta think of other games they can play. Because after... Like, I mean, like, regular games. Like, I can just play a random game if I really want. But games that I actually want to do more on a regular basis on the stream, you know, once I actually get back into doing streaming on a regular basis, because I wasn't planning to do 2 weeks between the last one and this one, but so much crap came up. Holy crap, he finished last. That's gonna help. I'm 11 points ahead of second place, so I can almost completely screw this race up and still win the tournament. I love it when that happens. But because I have this, which is going to take a while, but obviously I don't want to play it every stream. I don't even know if I want to play it the entire stream today. Then there's Undertale. But after I finish the True Pacifist run for that, I'm basically done with it. I'm not going to stream it again because there wouldn't really be any point. I could do Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare too. Oh, I got a car. I guess I didn't have that car before because it just gave it to me. It didn't even... Because usually it... Like the last few cars I've gotten, it's said, oh, you already have one of these in your garage. Do you want to sell this one? And the answer is immediately yes, because there's no reason for me to have two of the same car in my garage. There we go. That's the first one in a while that I've actually gotten that wasn't a duplicate car. What achievements am I close to getting? Obtained the gold wristband. I'm 90% of the way there. Well, I am, because that's 150 I need to get. Shut up. Stop talking. I know how the championship works. I have 175 cars in your garage. I will definitely get that before I finish all the tournaments, because I have 100 and says 78%, so I have probably like 125 around. I think I saw the stat while I was looking up. I was just looking up how close I was to 100% completion. I'm like 28% of the way there, so yay. But I think I have like 124, 125 cars in my garage. Aww. So I will definitely get that before I finish all of the tournaments. These are all Storm Island ones that I'm close to getting. And then the credits from Rivals is the next closest one in the main game. 100 million, yeah. That I would not do. I would just say, fuck that, I'm not getting that achievement. 1 million credits from Rivals. Which I am at 23% of the... 27% of the way. I can read. That's what I get for trying to read numbers while driving. Don't number and drive, kids. Don't math and drive. That's the lesson to take away from this. I think. Maybe. I'm not good with lessons. So, if first place isn't up in the top three, I can finish pretty much last and probably still win. Outside of that last race, I haven't won a single race yet. So, if I don't win this race, that's even better. That I can win the championship with only winning one race. He isn't first. So. Oh, I was gonna say, did you record a freaking game clip again? Because I didn't even know what I did, but half the time it's like, oh, you got. We recorded a game clip. Hang time. It's like, I was in the air. I did not even realize. But thank you, game, for recording a pointless game clip. It means exactly nothing to me. I missed that. Fuck. I'm gonna stick with it, because, oh god. Never mind. I was gonna stick with it, but I'm 65% of the way through and suddenly in last place. That's probably not gonna go over that well. What else do I have? Complete 100 championships, so yeah, I do have 25 championships done. And then there's Porsche ones and like the bucket list ones and the multiplayer ones that it's yelling at me about. Complete 25 online road trip locations. Apparently I've done 4. So that's gonna suck. I mean, the multiplayer ones aren't gonna be bad. There's the win 50 team races, so that one's gonna be a little bit of a bitch to get, because it kind of it depends not only on me but on other teammates. So if I end up with teammates that suck, or more likely I am the teammate that sucks, then that's gonna be a lot more time consuming to get. But considering I need to complete like 200 multiplayer events, 25 online road trip locations and all that stuff, I mean, it's gonna take a lot of time to get those too, so hopefully I'll get a decent amount of team event wins during that time. There's also the play like 100 playground games or something like that. Like the infection and the other thing. Oh, club tier 4 reached, that's great. Literally the only reason I have the club is because I wanted the achievement for gaining a bunch of experience for the club. I guess if you don't play for a while, that's how it drops you out, because I reached club tier 4 like 3 times. So I guess if you don't play for a while, it's like, oh, well, we're gonna give you back club tier 4. Thanks, game. I care about that. Best part is I'm club tier 4 when I'm the one that created the club. I'm the one that created the club and I can't even get to the top tier. Well, to be fair, it's not even based on, like, amount of time you play. It's based on, or not based on skill, it's based on amount of time you play. You could get to club tier 1 by completely sucking, but playing nonstop. Me, I'm glad it's not skill-based, because Otherwise, there'd be no way I would get to Club Tier 1. But it's also not an achievement, so I don't care enough. So, I won by a lot.
That's another championship in the bag.
And I only won one race. Like, that's the best part. I won the championship only winning one race.
Hey, mate, I only need two more championships. I think it was a little rusty at first, just a little. But now I'm back in full swing. I'll be waiting for you in the finale. See you on the grid, champ.
Oh, he's gonna be in the finale. That's... Is that what's different? That he's racing, he's gonna be in the finale? Is he actually gonna be in the finale, though? Or is it gonna be one of those where I'm just racing against, you know, other people's drivatars? And it's like, oh yeah, he's okay, in the finale, he's in the finale. It's like, I didn't see him. Well, he was there. You just didn't see him. He was invisible.
I could fast travel, but that'd be really lazy considering it's right in front of me. I mean, it definitely sounds like something I would do, but, okay, so what are the other cars that I need to do? There's a bunch of Porsche cars, a bunch of Porsche ones, but the MG Metro R4 and the Mitsubishi Galant. I don't know what they are under. Let's see hypercars. Maybe I'll do one of the Porsche ones. I don't know if there would be a Porsche under a hypercar, or if they're all under like sports cars and stuff. 918 Spider is, I know that's one of them. Complete four events in the 2014 Porsche 918 Spider. I guess I know what I'm driving. Let's make it all the colors. Or just one color. Obtain this free car. Thanks, game. You're a pal. Oh, cool. I got an achievement for buying a Porsche. Did I really not have one? Or is it because now I have the DLC, I can unlock it? Because did I really not have one? I figured that'd be something that I would have had. Is this one... Because there's a bunch of, like... Oh, win a race in the wet. Basically, in the rain. Pull off 20 drifts in that one. Pull off 30 near miss skills in that one. Now, it's just win four events.
Now, this road trip is moving on. This time to San Giovanni. And remember, this isn't about getting there first. It's about enjoying the journey.
And crashing into a bunch of walls, apparently, for me. Because God forbid I drive, you know, well.
Turn left.
Oh. Into a tree. Through a fence. Through more fence. Almost into cars. Actually into cars. Not an almost anymore. Get on the road. I think that went well. That was only the first mile of the road trip. 5.5 more to go. I guarantee I'm going to hit more things. Like there. Good thing I don't need skill points, so it doesn't matter if I crash into everything. I don't need skill points anymore, so... I only need 5 more and I get 100,000 credits, which doesn't really matter because I have plenty. I have plenty of credits, and most of the cars that I've been getting are end up being DLC cars, which you don't have to buy. It's like, oh, you... Like, well, I guess I technically did have to buy them, but I don't have to buy them with in-game money. It's... Oh, you unlock this car, you can obtain it for free. Alright, cool. I could get, just with the free cars, I could get the 175 cars owned achievement. We're good. Saved it. And by saved it, I mean I just waited until it flipped itself back over. I did exactly nothing.
Yards,
I don't care about the pictures.
Right.
I only cared about them, really. I mean, I still get them just to get rid of that freaking icon. But oh my god, this is gonna suck. This next tournament is going to suck. I mean, how I'm driving. I mean, to be fair, I'm being way less cautious, because I don't have to be. I can drive as fast as I want. It doesn't really matter. I'm just going right over there. I don't need to get there first or anything. But considering how much I've crashed just on the way here, it's not going to go well. Tell you what I'm going to do. Because I really don't want this to go on for a while. Unless I hit a tournament where I just can't beat it, where it's just takes so many tries, like this one probably will. I'm gonna do 4 more tournaments just to get to the second Horizon finale, do the second Horizon finale, and then I'll switch over to something else. I think that's good. I feel like this is a game that I'm gonna have to do in my spare time, because if I just do it when I stream, it's gonna take forever. It's gonna take so long, especially the multiplayer. The multiplayer, one thing, because it's always gonna be somewhat different. I mean, it's also pretty much the same because it's just races. It's not really anything special. But, I feel like they're all gonna be time consuming. I might do Undertale. I actually do kind of feel like... I feel like doing the True Pacifist run today. I mean, at least starting it. But I think part of that's more... not really because I just really want to play Undertale. It's more because I just don't want to have that, like, hanging over my head. This, I know, is going to take a while. So I'm completely fine with this just still hanging there. Like, oh, hey, I need to do Forza Horizon 2 at some point. But Undertale's one of those, it's only gonna take, like, 4 hours, I bet. Like, the entire True Pacifist run, outside of reading the story and stuff like that, is probably gonna take, like, a total of 4 or 5 hours. If I have to go by, like, the main game and the Genocide run, minus Sans' battle, it's only gonna take, like, 4 or 5 hours. So I kinda wanna get it out of the way. You know, not leave it for another week or two. But, we'll see. Alright. Let's checkpoint. I'm actually not doing too bad. I didn't upgrade this car, I realized. I should probably do that between races. I mean, the upgrade's not really going to do much. It might make it faster, make it harder for me to use. But if anything, I'll get, like, better tires and have better traction and stuff like that. Hopefully. I think this is one of those cars where there's not really a lot of engine upgrades due to the fact that it's, you know, already fast as shit. Holy hell. This is still on highly skilled. That's the one thing about the... Oh, I really cut it close to everything there. And then I cut it really close to that tree. I have to win 4 events, which does count the rival things, as I found out. So, if I lose any of these, I will just do a rival. Actually, no, because the rival one's doing, like, time trials and that. That's actually probably worse. It might be better to just restart the race if it looks like I'm going to get second in that and try it from there. I mean, I could always just leave it and then do it in a either multiplayer or... Well, multiplayer, no, because there's zero... Like I said before, there's zero chance of me actually winning a multiplayer race. Ever. Like, it doesn't matter what car I'm in, especially in something like this. There's zero chance. So, I should probably just restart and try to do these. I could always do more tournaments. But... whatever. I got one. 25% complete for that one. It's one out of the way. And another level toward the gold wristband. Bring it. That's right, I almost forgot I need to do those. I get an item for that one. Oh, that's in-game reward for XP. Looking at just the gamer score alone, it looks like the Porsche ones are the ones that give a lot of gamer score. Like the Porsche DLC ones are the ones that give a lot of gamer score. Not that I really care about the gamer score, but the only like big one is like, what is it, complete 40 events in Porsches. And that's like 100 gamer score right there. I don't know if it said win or complete. Actually, that might not even be right. I might have just completely butchered the description and stuff for that achievement. Am I winning? Target is 232, 556. These are always so much easier a lot of the time. Always a lot of the time. The sprint ones are usually easier because the ghost gets the same start as you, whereas the lap races, you might have to do two or three laps until you get it because you get such an awful start and the ghost is usually on the second or third lap, like, because it gets like a running start basically. But the sprint races, your car and the ghost usually get pretty similar starts. If anything, the ghost gets a worse start because it's usually someone doing it from the single player and not from the rival race or anything like that, so they end up starting back in like 8th place of their race. They're further behind. You get a little bit of a head start, but also there's no cars, and I don't know, I'm kind of like in the middle. Like some games, this game, I think the time trials I usually do way better. But then you get like Need for Speed Hot Pursuit, you get Split Second, you get any of those races. The time trials I do, or any of those games, the time trials I do so much worse. So much worse. But that, to be fair, that could just be the fact that the target time is just so much more ridiculous than here. Here, the target time was based off of my time, so I should be able to improve that time without any other cars around me. And I clearly did. Holy crap. That was actually really easy. I beat my time by 3 seconds. Or I beat the target time by 3 seconds. My time, I think, was a little more than that. So, I mean, still beat my time by over 3 seconds. Alright. I'll take it. Between this one and the last one, these two tournaments, I got 4 tournaments worth. Oh, I hit the X button. I told him to bring it. I didn't want him to bring it. No. No. And that's technically a second event, I think. So I think I'm technically... No. I don't think it... Oh! First of all, I don't think it worked. Second of all, I just realized the achievement description says complete 4 events in the Porsche 918 Spyder. So, I'm good. And it is complete 40 events in Porsches. Yeah. So, basically I need to do 10 tournaments in Porsches. I also need to do the bucket list. I have, I think, one of them done. Complete 10 events in the same Porsche. Oh, so I need to do... I need to have the same one for, like... Well, it's complete 10 events, so I could always just do those in multiplayer. I don't necessarily need to do those in single player. which I probably won't be able to, because I'm sure it's going to get to a point where I'm out of tournaments where I can actually use them. I'm out of tournaments where I can actually... I still haven't upgraded this car, I realized. I'm supposed to do that. Whoops. Well, now that I know I just have to complete four events and not win four events, I'm completely fine with not upgrading this car. It's pretty damn awesome already. And I can already barely control it. If it gets any faster, goddamn. Like there. Okay, I'm just humping the wall at that point. I'm just gonna restart. I kind of want to get to the Rising finale, but if I get bored of this game before then... I love how I'm already talking about, you know, if I get bored of this game before then... I haven't even been streaming for an hour yet, and I'm already like, you know, maybe I could play something else. That's how much the idea of having 168 freaking tournaments, 142 including this one that I have to do yet, is just like, oh, that's gonna suck. That's gonna suck. Plus the fact that it's hot in here, so I don't really want to have a... I kind of want to do a game that I have to pay attention to less. Like, I don't want to... Sorry, got distracted. I really got focused right there for some reason. But I want to play a game like Undertale. Some of the battles I will have to actually pay attention to, but for the most part, I'm not gonna have too much of a difficulty with them. Especially after Sans' battle, there's no way that I'm gonna have any that are even remotely as difficult. Shit. I brought it back a little bit. I saved it a little bit. I did crash, but I'm still in third, so I'll take it. I missed that. Missing a checkpoint in this game is brutal. Because you miss a checkpoint, you're basically... Because it takes 5 seconds for it to freaking respawn you. It's like if it respawned you after, like, a second or two, it's like, checkpoint missed, and then you... could, you know, hit a button to respawn or something like that. Like, you have the option to either go back or hit a button and try to respawn. That would be better. Because then... It wouldn't really... Oops. That'd be better, because then it's like, oh, I missed the checkpoint. Instantly hit the button to respawn, and you wouldn't end up... Like, the one race where I ended up going from, like, 2nd to 12th. And there was zero chance of me actually pulling it back at that point. So... Hopefully this goes better. I don't know who got second and third in that, so I don't know who I need to worry about winning the race. Oh, it was him. Okay. So... I mean, either way, I still want to win. I still want to increase my lead, if anything. Rather than using this as the race where it's like, oh, well, I can get third and still be good, and then having to get first or second the next two races. I would rather be way ahead than just on the bubble. thought I was gonna miss that one. Luckily I kind of bounced to the right. I turned way too early. Well, I did turn way too early, but I thought it was gonna screw me over. It didn't. We're good. It was saved. Three laps. I'm used to Storm Island. Storm Island, I feel like every race is two laps if they're a lap race. These, they're all three. And it's always a pain in the ass, pretty much. Luckily, Storm Island has like. What was it? Besides the Gauntlet races, has like 24 total. That's, I think, six tiers, and I mean, I think total then it's like 30 championships, but six of those are Gauntlet races. One of those was the introductory one that was, you know, one race, and a bunch of them have three. So unlike this, where it's 168 freaking tournaments, each one has four races. So that's what, too many. For the Storm Island, it's a lot less. It's a whole lot less. Oh, I'm done. I didn't realize I was that close to the finish. See, that's easy when I don't crash into trees and flip over. It's really easy. It's not really that the other racers are good, it's that I just have to be not bad. Cool. The other thing is I like how I don't even have to grind XP in this game. Because if I'm just going for 100%, I'm gonna get the gold no matter what. Like, it's gonna happen. It's not one of those, oh, well, it'll happen, but you have to, you know, you're gonna have to grind for a while. It's, no, you just play the game, it'll come natural progression of the game. Because there's so many goddamn races, and I gain like 2 levels per tournament. I gain like 2 levels per tournament, and then you gain even more. You gain a ton of experience from multiplayer. It may or may not. I think it's more than single player, but it may or may not be. Either way, it piles up fast. I think it is more than single player because you have the long drives between each event. So, technically, if you base it on like amount of time per experience, is probably not as much, or maybe about the same, but either way, it's one of those games that there's just so many ways to get experience that it doesn't really matter. Oops, I fucked it. I'm good, we're good, I'm upside down. We are not good. This 3 laps? Fuck it, I'm going for it. Oh, he stopped. Thank you for that. Thank you for not breaking my everything. It's probably a stupid idea to go for this, but yeah. I've already caught up to 10th, 9th, and 8th, and 7th, and I see most of the rest of them. Holy crap, this is not good. Oh my god. Now I'm last. Great. I hit that pretty hard. I suck at this. This is why I was going with like C-class cars and for the last one, because I was like, the Ford Fiesta, I had the opportunity to upgrade it to like class A. This is why I didn't. This one's S2 by default without any upgrades. And I am losing miserably. If I'm still like right around last after this lap, I'm just gonna reset. I'm gonna restart. I screwed up right there last lap. That's when everything went downhill. And now I'm in like catch-up mode, which means I'm rushing everything. I'm not taking turns as neatly as I should. And it's causing me to just end up further back. Well, I'm in not last place, so that's something. I can end up in not second to last place as well. I'm in 10th, and I'm actually not far behind most of them. I mean, we can see how this goes. We can finish out the race and see how this goes. I think what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna start doing bucket list stuff. Just because I really kind of want to do bucket list stuff. I don't know, as soon as I started this, it's like, I don't really want to do tournaments. And I think like I said, it's just because of the whole fact that I look at how many tournaments I need to do yet, and it's like, holy crap. I still need to do 142 tournaments. There's just so goddamn many. Plus now I'm talking about Undertale, and now I really want to play that as well. Okay, fuck this. As soon as that tree jumped in front of me, I didn't hit it, it jumped in front of me. That's gonna be my story forever. But, as soon as that happened, I knew it, this is not going great. Not going great. What is that? Impurest Ocean. I love trying to read their names while I'm driving. Because I already suck at reading. I already suck at, you know, seeing things. So, trying to see those while there's all kind of motion blur and stuff. Well, not even motion blur, but all kind of, you know, issue, you know, the text is far away and it's moving like across the screen in like a second. Hard as hell to see. It's so much fun to see how much I can butcher people's names. Especially since I'm the kind, I butcher names on a regular basis. Pretty much anyone that's followed my stream has probably heard me butcher names more times than not. As soon as I get, like, I think out of like the, what was it, 21 followers I have, probably like 10 of them, as soon as I got the follow notification, I was like, thank you, oh god, I gotta read this name. I just suck at pronunciations. I suck at speaking, in general. I think that's pretty obvious. I'm in third, that's actually not bad. If I get second, I'm good. Because I have one first place finish over him. So if he gets first, it's, aw, fuck you! Stupid corner. Never mind. Because this would actually this would even us up, I believe. Because I have... If I finish fourth, it would have evened us up, because I'm 8 points ahead of him. Because he got second in both of the last two races. So that would bring it to... That would bring it to... Well, he crashed. So fourth place, I would get 12, you'd get 20, so that would even us up, and I would just have to finish ahead of him in the last race. So if I get fourth, I'm good. I would prefer anything better than that, but... Like, first would be a great one, but I don't see that happening because I have been playing catch-up this entire race, even when I haven't screwed up. when I do screw up, that's pretty much guaranteeing that I'm going to be playing catch up for the rest of the race or just restarting, because there's no way. It's one of the things I hate about doing like highly skilled and stuff. The fact that I'm doing highly skilled because the difficulty curve in this game is weird. I think I mentioned it in one of my videos recently. I talked about it. The difficulty curve on this game is awful. Because there isn't a curve. It's, well, I mean, there's a curve, but it's... it's more of like the, what is it, seismometer, seismograph, or whatever, the one that measures earthquakes, or a lie detector or something. That's more what the curve, the difficulty curve of this game looks like. There's no curve. It's basically, it gets difficult, and then in the same tournament, you could have a race that's just insanely easy and no, there's no issues with it. And that's on any difficulty. I've had that on highly skilled. I had that on... oh god, I crashed. I suck. No, stay in front. Stay ahead of him. Finish at least fourth. God dang it. No. I need to finish at least fourth, because then I'm going to be at least tied with first place for the last race. And then I still need to finish first in the last race, which isn't going to happen, because I'm clearly not good at video games, especially not racing games. But doesn't mean I'm not going to try. Doesn't mean I'm not going to try. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I came in too hot. I did all the wrong everything. Finish line's right over there. I screwed that up. Hey Flora, how's it going? As you can see, there's more than just Undertale that I suck at. It's pretty much any game. Only racing game I'm good at is Crash Team Racing. Yeah! Yeah, Crash Team Racing. I'm pretty decent at that one, too. Great, now I feel like playing Crash Team Racing. But, yeah, any game that has, like, actual cars in racing, I'm not usually, great with. Especially when the cars are ridiculously fast, like this one. I've been trying to choose, like, slower cars, but I need an achievement, so I... well, I didn't need the achievement, I wanted the achievement, so I chose this car. And clearly it's not going great. Love the old Crash games. Yeah, they are ridiculously fun. I don't think... Crash Team Racing, I don't think I've ever beaten 100%, but I feel like I've done... I did 1 and 2, I think I've done 3. God dang it! I'm doing this. Do I want to lower the difficulty? Yes, because... screw it. I was planning to do enough tournaments to get to the... I need to do like 5 tournaments to get to the Horizon finale. I was gonna do that, and then switch over to probably Undertale. And then, who knows? Maybe I'll get frustrated enough that I won't even do 5 tournaments. I'll do... you know, this one. I mean, I already beat 1. The first one wasn't that bad. This one, not going as great. I should not... Well, I lowered the difficulty, so I should be able to come back from that. I think it is safe to say I should never drive a Porsche. Oh, God. I didn't run in head first. I feel like doing a marathon of Crash 1, 2, 3, and Crash Team Racing. That sounds fun. I've been feeling like doing the original Spyro games, the first three Spyro games. Because I've done those 100% as well. But it's one of those where I don't care if I've done them 100% like five times. They're still ridiculously fun. It was funny, because when Rare Replay came out for Xbox One, I remember seeing someone say in one of, like, forums and stuff, they were like, because the achievements were shared, like, all the Xbox 360 games, you didn't get, it wasn't new achievements, they were the same achievements as they were in Xbox 360, so if you already had them in the 360 version, you already had them with Rare Replay. So I remember seeing someone that was like, I was hoping for new achievements. I wanted to play Banjo-Kazooie again. It's like, just because you have the achievements doesn't mean you can't play Banjo-Kazooie. Just because you have the achievements, just because you've beaten it before, doesn't mean it's off limits now. It's not like, oh, you finish this game and then the Xbox just locks you out of the game forever. I mean, as soon as I got Rare Replay, that was, like, two of the first games I did, Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, despite the fact that I beat them, like, three times 100% each. And, okay, I actually need semi-focus. Even though I lowered the difficulty, so this should actually be fine. I'm in second, which is... The fact that I lowered the difficulty and still can't get first should tell you something. But, I just did it. Played through Undertale about 20 times, maybe more. Yeah, I've played through it too.
Okay, that's not too bad.
Like two times. I mean, I'll probably play through it more, probably not on stream, to do, you know, after I do the True Passives run, I'll probably play through it more just to find secrets and stuff, but maybe not on stream, because that's going to be boring, because it's basically going to be me looking at guides and going, oh, okay, so I need to go here and do this thing. Where am I at Undertale? I didn't start the True Passives run. I probably will start that later in the stream. I haven't streamed for, like, 2 weeks. I've wanted to, but I just haven't. Just so busy with so much other crap that I haven't had to. So I want to do that. I want to do the True Pacifist run. And then I think that's it then for, like, what I'm going to be streaming and recording and stuff. And I'll move on to other games. I need to figure out other games to do in addition to this. Because Forza, I'm not going to just do Forza until I beat it 100%. Because there's 168 tournaments. And I've beaten 26, this is the 27th, so, I'm definitely gonna need a break from that. It's just a matter of whether or not I want to do a game that I haven't played before and try to do stuff in it, or... cannot remember your channel, a lot of stuff been going on lately. Well, luckily, I don't think I've streamed since the last one you were at. I don't think I've had a stream since then, so, but yeah, a lot of stuff been going on lately for me too, so I've just have not, like, every time I plan to stream, something comes up and it's like, god damn it, I just want to play Forza and Undertale and some other game, insert game here, I don't know. But
okay, you've done really well.
Shut up. Shut up. I know I need to win this next race. Shut up. Go away. You played Fez? I have not. I've heard good things about it, but I haven't played it, personally. I don't even think I've seen any, like, gameplay of it. Like, because there's a lot of games where it's like, oh, well, I kind of want to play this, but I just haven't gotten around to it, and I'll still watch gameplay stuff of it. That one's one I don't think I've actually seen anything of it. But yeah, there's just so many games. See, I kind of want to... Part of me doesn't want to start new games. Part of me wants to go back to games that I've already started, either whether it was for like a YouTube series or whether it was just something I did in my spare time. And I just want to go back and beat all those because I have so many games started that I want to finish. And I mean, there's a lot of games that I've done for series that I've beaten the stories, but I want to go back and do them 100%, and I just haven't had a chance. Watching gameplay might spoil it because it's a puzzle platformer. Yeah, I guess that would. Probably. Especially, you know, the puzzle part of it. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Awful. Nope. Let's just ignore that one. Ignore that one, Mulligan. But it's a matter of, especially once I'm done with the True Pacifist Run of Undertale, whether I want to start, because I want to kind of do that so it's not hanging over my head. It's one thing that I'm like, oh, I want to do this, I'm going to do this, and just haven't done it yet. Whoops. No one saw that. Some of the puzzles are crazy. Yeah, some of those, like, really intense puzzle games can get, like, really crazy, so I wouldn't be surprised if that one's one of those as well. But I don't know, there's a lot of games, it's like, do I want to start, because I've been doing, god, what games are there that I haven't finished that I've started relatively recently? Pretty much everything in Rare Replay. Like, so many games there, so many achievements and stuff that I need to get. Oh, god damn it. Sunset Overdrive. I've finished the story and then have not gone back to it, despite the fact that I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna beat this 100%, I'm gonna beat this 100%, and then just haven't played it since. What else is there? I know I started, not on recording or stream or anything, I started Resident Evil Zero, because I have the Resident Evil Origins collection, but I didn't beat that one. I should have to do that, especially since I'll probably do some of those, the Resident Evil games, for a series, because I finished my Resident Evil Outbreak series, so kind of want to do some more Resident Evil stuff. Okay, Eric. See, what I gotta do is, I keep looking down and, like, checking chat. It's like, no, don't do that in the middle of a race. Don't do that in the middle of a race. That's what's causing you to crash more. I mean, that's not what's causing me to crash more. What's causing me to crash more is because I'm awful. Because I have no skills whatsoever. Oh. That trash can or whatever I ran over that sabotaged me. Yeah, I really like puzzle games, so I probably would like that game. Whether, again, it's one of those, whether or not I want to play it on stream, I'm not sure, because I kind of want to get through games that I've already had started and not start something completely new, but, who knows, maybe. Although, to be fair, one of the games that I was planning to potentially start was Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2, despite the fact that it's been out for few months. I haven't played it. Finally bought it. Haven't started it up yet, but the only reason I haven't started it up is like, do I want to finish these games before I start that? Probably should. I mean, I don't expect to finish Forza Horizon 2 before I start anything else because, again, 168 tournaments. God dang it. I keep distracting myself from how many tournaments there are in this game, and then every time I think about it, it's like 168 tournaments. I'm on 27. There's a reason why I didn't do 100% completion for my YouTube series on this, because I knew it was going to take forever. And there's a reason why I'm probably going to do a lot of stuff not streaming, like a lot of trying to get 100% on this, because... Oh, no, 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 I screwed up here again. I'm good. I'm safe. I'm good. We're awesome. I can catch up and not die. If I get second, I think I'm technically in... I technically win the tournament, because I think I tie for first, and you always win a tiebreaker in this game, which is good, because it's happened multiple times, and if I didn't win the tiebreaker, I would cry. But I just really need to... I really need to not screw this up. I screwed it up. I'm not going to win this. Again, I wanna point out, I set this back down to average, and I'm still screwing up this badly. Because I'm starting to realize it doesn't have anything to do with how good the AI is. It has to do with the fact that I'm completely awful at this game and can't win a race to save my life. Can I win? If I didn't crash into that car, I might have been able to pass him, but... Okay. 17th time's the charm. The more I play this game, the more frustrated I'm getting. Because I thought, oh, well, I'm going to just play this game a bunch, try to make a ton of progress in this, and basically get as far as I can in this. Like, I wasn't planning to stream anything else, and now I'm like, you know, Undertale's look... Oh, I camered. Whoops. But now I'm thinking, you know, Undertale's looking pretty good right now. That True Pacifist run, I wasn't gonna do it today. I was gonna do it sometime during the week, probably. But it's like, oh, that's actually looking pretty good. Maybe I should do that instead. An indie fanboy. Well, I mean, to be fair, there are a lot of good indie games out there. I mean, there's a decent amount of good AAA games that have come out recently, but indie games is one of those that's like, it always feels like the people that make indie games actually have good ideas. It's not like, oh, let's put out the 7th version of this game and change absolutely nothing because, you know, it sold last time. It's actually like, okay, well, I feel like doing something like this. Well, let's do it, because fuck it, why not? And then it usually turns out pretty good. I mean, one of the games that... I stopped playing it for a while because I had, like, Sunset Overdrive and a bunch of other games that I was playing, but one of the games that I've been playing pretty much non-stop for a while, not on stream or anything... Not on stream. I did play it on stream. I did do a video on it, but I've been playing it a lot off-stream and stuff. Love challenging, punishing myself in games. Did a playthrough of Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix on Critical Level 1. Yeah. But, yeah, me, I'm the kind, I don't mind challenging games, but as long as, yeah, I mean, I don't mind challenging games sometimes, It depends on the kind of challenging. If that made any sense, like... But one of the games I've been playing pretty much non-stop off-stream and all that... is, Binding of Isaac. I've been playing that so much. That's one game. It's just so much fun. Even though, again, like most games, I absolutely suck at it. And it, I'm usually the kind, I do a ton of runs and I get like a negative 27 win streak on it before I actually finish a run. But it's just so much fun. Even failing miserably in Binding of Isaac is so much fun. What runs do you have in Undertale so far? I've done... I did, like, a normal run for YouTube series, which was the... Yeah, I just did, like, a normal... It was just a regular run. Mostly because it was my first run, I was just like, I don't want to either be all good or all bad. I ended up, like, killing some things, not killing other things. And... I don't remember how much I actually killed. I think I ended up killing Toriel just because I didn't know I could spare her. And then didn't kill anyone else. But... Then I did the genocide run. I mostly just wanted to do, like, the Genocide and True Passus run after the series. Like, those two are the ones that I really just want to do, for the most part. I mean, fucking hell. I mean, I'll probably play more runs eventually. It's just one of those where it's like, I don't want to just do Undertale for a while. Like, I don't want to do, like, 20 runs on camera. Like, I don't want to do 20 runs on stream or as a series or something. I think doing the one playthrough for the series and then doing the True Pacifist and Genocide are enough for recording, at least. But I definitely will play through it again. I absolutely don't doubt that. Whether or not it's just to get specific secrets, like, oh, well, I want to see this with my own eyes, I want to do this. Especially since when I do the True Pacifist, I'm doing it on a fresh save file. Like, I backed up my old save files from the app data, and basically I'm going to do it without the... Because I know there's some differences, like with the ending at least, if you've done the Genocide run beforehand. So I want to do... a True Pacifist run without the Genocide run completed, so I'm sure in my spare time I'm going to do a True Pacifist run with it completed. Like, you know, put in my old save files and go through it again. Definitely using my old save files, because, God, I do not want to fight Sans again. I do not want to spend another 4 hours trying to fight Sans. But, God, I don't think I won. No, I wouldn't have done it. By the way, I finally got the 1% on Binding of Isaac Afterbirth, the nerd times. I don't know what that means. Mostly because I only have, like... I'm not even remotely far in the game, so I'm not... sure exactly what that means. Despite the fact that I've played it a lot, I'm still not that far in the game. I mean, I do have... like... 20% of the achievements, a little over 20% of the achievements, so it's not like I'm super, like, early in the game, but... Sans is really fun, now he's kind of boring. I mean, yeah, I guess it's one of those boss battles that after you beat it once, it's probably... Or maybe a few more times, it might be fun, but after you beat it a little bit, it's like... alright, I know kind of what to expect from the battle, from the moves and stuff. I would think Flowey's kind of the same way. Like, fighting him once is interesting because it's like, holy crap, this is completely different from anything that I've faced in the game so far. And then afterwards, it's like, yeah, okay, I know what to do. That's kind of why I mostly just want to do the true pacifist route on stream. Because I feel like if doing any of the other neutral routes, stuff's going to be different, but not different enough where it'll make sense to have a full, like, recording and streaming and all that stuff. True pacifist route, at least. God damn it. I cannot get that turn without completely screwing it up. And I see the chat move, and I'm trying to refrain from looking at the chat, so I don't... I need to get second. I need to get second, at least. See, I wanna not look at the chat. I wanna wait until after this race so I don't screw it up. I'm in second, so that's good. Again, I wanna point out, I lowered the difficulty and I'm still doing absolutely awful. I feel like I should just play, like I've been playing a game for YouTube called Monster Loves You. Basically just a choose your own adventure game. That kind of game I could play. That requires no skill whatsoever. It's just, oh, here's some dialogue options. Choose one. That I can do fine. Apparently anything that requires skill, no. Watch a new Top Gear last night with Chris Evans and Matt LeBlanc. No, I did not. I do kind of want to see it, though, just to see how it is. It is definitely interesting.
Mate, that was some immense driving. You just added another challenge.
Ring Wraith. Bleep, four events in the 2014 Porsche 918 Spyder. So got that one. And no other achievements, great. I don't know why I expected any other achievements, that's the only one that I wanted to go for. Or the only one, not the only one I wanted to go for, the only one that I was going for in that specific run. Oh, okay. I think what I'll go do quick. Doing the Undertale Pacifist Challenge run. You may not use healing items, or you may not change your armor. I mean, I don't know how difficult that'd be in the Pacifist run. Huh.
All right. That was the last.
Mostly because I don't really know fully what the Pacifist run entails. I know it's basically... Actually, if you have to face any of the people in any of the people you do in the neutral run, then obviously it's going to be difficult. It's good. Some people say it was rubbish and call it flop gear. I have a feeling that's just people. It's like, because people don't like change, so it's like, oh, this isn't the same three people. So, this immediately sucks. It's like, just because it's different people doesn't mean it's gonna suck. It's gonna be different. It might not be the same, it might not be the same humor and stuff. But that doesn't necessarily mean it's not gonna be good. You loved it? I mean, yeah, I definitely want to watch it. Obviously, I want to watch it and decide for myself whether it's good, but, I mean... I'm not one that usually listens to critics and stuff anyway, or critics or just general opinion. Mostly because even with just games, looking at games, well, TV shows too, but thank you, Gareth, for following. I crashed into a tree. That wasn't because of you. I was going to crash into the tree anyway, but I figured that was a good time to thank you for following, because I wasn't moving anyway. But, oh, that's a car. But yeah, it's one of those, even with games and other TV shows and stuff, it's you know, there's plenty of times when people say, oh, this sucks, or oh, this is great. And I feel like the exact opposite way of the general opinion. So that's why it's like, I want to watch it, I want to get my own impression of it, and not just listen to people saying, oh, it sucked. I might not think it sucks. I mean, there are a lot of games like that. I changed camera again. My one friend, me and him, you know, we program games together. But there's so many games where he's like, oh yeah, this game is great, this game is awesome. I play and it's like, wow, this is not good. And there are plenty of games where he's like, oh yeah, that game, you won't like it, it sucked. And I play it and can't put it down. Do you remember that Stained Apron in Undertale? I mean, I'm sure I picked it up at some point. Off the top of my head, I don't remember. But, I'm sure I did have it, and have it equipped probably at some point. I vaguely remember an apron. Oop, almost crashed into everything. The question is, after this, because the tournaments, I'm doing god-awful in them. Hidden path up from where you find it. Alright, I'll have to try to remember that. Unless I do it this stream and get to that point, then if you're still here, you can yell at me. When I ultimately forget about it, you can yell at me and go, no! No! You gotta go up and do the thing. But... oh, I'm in a field. I'm not even on the road. Question is, what do I want to do after I... yes, drive through the forest in a Porsche. That's going to be the smart decision. That's exactly what's the best decision here. What do I want to do bucket list items? Because I don't know. I'm getting frustrated at the tournaments already. I've done 2 tournaments and I'm already getting frustrated with them. To be fair, I am driving an insanely fast car through a forest, so I don't know what I expect from that, but do I want to do bucket list items that I'm ultimately going to fail at? Do I want to try to do more tournaments that I'm ultimately going to fail at? Or do I want to go to Storm Island and do the collectibles, which it's physically impossible to fail at. I mean, I think that's a pretty obvious choice right there.
Made it. And now it's time to party before we head out for tomorrow's road trip.
Yeah, great, shut up. Wait, was that 3? Oh yeah, 27 is divisible by 3. Duh. I don't know why I failed the math right there. I was like, wait a minute. I need to win 3 more championships. Like, part of me was like, oh, I really want to do 3 more championships.
You leveled up.
See how it goes, but at the same time, it's like, I kind of want to not do 3 championships. VIP will spin, because I bought all of the DLC because I'm an idiot. Basically because it was all on sale as like the DLC pack, and I was like, it was like 60% off all DLC. I'm like, yeah, fuck it, why not? Even though all of the DLC that I got, only like 2 of them I actually wanted. But I bought them because reasons. Okay, let's go to Storm Island, because you know it's all off-road, which great for a sports car. You know, sports cars and off-road, they go together like 2 things. I'm not good with metaphors. Or speaking in general, but metaphors especially. Load up. Load up. You loaded up another loading screen. Load up the actual game. Come on. I know it's a different island, but you can do it. Yeah, see, I have all of everything on there because the treasure map was included in the thing, and I activated it because if I didn't activate the treasure map, first of all, I would have paid for it for nothing. I mean, it was included in the whole DLC pack, so it wouldn't have really mattered, but also I would have just, to get all the collectibles, I would have just looked them up anyway. Honestly. That's what I did with the main island, I just looked up a map, because that was before I bought all the DLC. I looked up a map and I was like, oh, well, I should go here. I should go do this thing.
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
No, shut up, GPS.
Calculating route.
Not the boss of me. I'm not going to turn around. I'm going to come out here, get this one, then turn around. And then still not go the way you're telling me to go. Luckily, there's not a lot of collectibles in this, so I can get through it pretty quickly, especially since I've been doing Storm Island, so... I've been doing Storm Island, I've been driving around it for a while, so I should be good. Not to mention, I don't really need to drive too far between different things, because I have the free fast travel, because I got a fast travel board, so... We're good. And then I can... Oh, I only need one more road. Awesome. And then I can switch to Undertale. Because I really... Like, when I started the stream, I was like, yeah, I'll play Forza Horizon the entire stream. I'm gonna be completely fine with that. And then the more I started talking about other games, it's like, you know, I feel like playing this. I feel like playing this. So I think I want to do Undertale, get that out of the way. I mean, I won't finish it today, probably. It'll probably be like halfway through the True Passes run. And then... Especially since I'm pretty sure it's not going to go as fast as the Genocide run, because even though I'm not going to have to kill everything and all that, I don't have to do any grinding to... Oh, I need to get 3 more enemies in this area, so I gotta wait for a random encounter. Even though I don't have to do that, I still... There's gonna be a lot more story that I'm gonna be reading, so... That's gonna take longer, probably. Get the freaking board! God dang it. Okay, there's one over here. Can I fast travel to the board, or is it gonna put me on the... On the road near... I was gonna say, it's gonna put me on the road near it. That'd be hilarious if I fast travel to it and it just put me right on top of the board. As soon as I spawn, it's like, oh, 18 out of 25. I mean, it might as well put me right on top of the board. It put me like 2 feet from it, but... I like having all the perks. I like having the fast travel anywhere perk. The one over there. There's this road that I need to drive, and a bunch of... I wanted to fast travel, not for you to show me a leaderboard. I guess I can't fast travel directly on them. I guess it makes sense that I can't fast travel directly on them, because why would you want to? I don't care about actual, like, times. Or not times, but actual speeds, because I have the... First of all, I don't know if any of my friends have this, but I have the achievement for beating, like, 25 of your friends' speed trap speeds or something like that, speed trap records. I don't remember what it was, but I have that achievement, so... I don't need to worry about those. I just need to get them. Goddamn trees. Porsches and forests don't mix. Okay, there's one here. I'll go get that one quick. This is actually going way faster than I thought. So I might do some of the whatchamacallits. Yeah, those things. If only my brain worked and I could actually think about stuff. Oh god, it's up there. I can't even. How do I up? But I might do some bucket list items, just as like a. Oh hey, here's how we're gonna end the Forza Horizon part of the stream. I don't want to go here. Go away. Go away. Go away, music. Don't need your thumping. I knew I was gonna crash into that. So why wouldn't I? Is there scenery around? I'm gonna crash into it. I always thought I was just a tree magnet, but I only ran into trees. I run into everything. Okay, so go to this one. Is this three achievements? Bonus board, drive every road? I don't know. Actually, I don't know if there's one for the speed traps. I'm gonna get them anyway, but I don't think there's one for the speed traps, actually. An achievement. I at least I don't see one on the list of achievements. Who knows? Oh wow, I nailed that speed zone. That crash clearly did everything for me. Okay, let's just keep going up because there's the one up here. Let's keep going up through the trees. That's a smart idea. There's only three more boards, one more road, and a decent amount of things. Do I have Storm Island progress? That's not the progress that I wanted. Let's do the stats. Storm Island. 83% towards the Storm Island finale. Who cares? Roads discovered. Unique board smash. One of each of those. And then no bucket list progress. Is that on the current bucket list, or what? Because I thought it said 10% on the bucket list. Progress. Alright. Apparently the game and the achievements can't agree on anything. So let's go here. Go up, get that board, get that speed zone, drive that road, and then get the other board. We're good. That made sense to someone. Barely made sense to me, so. Keep on the path because there's no trees, so clearly that's gonna help me way more. And it's around here somewhere. There it is. Go. I don't know if there's a minimum speed you have to have in the speed zone before it just says, yeah, you're not gonna do this. But hopefully I've gotten it. Oh, no, I did. It let me get there. Because I think if you, like, stop still, it doesn't continue, like, counting up. I think it just gives up after a while, but I guess I didn't stop that much where it was just like, yeah, give up. Oops, I didn't crash. That's a surprise. Trying out a new stealth setup in Warframe. Oh, good! Game clip recorded, hang time, that's useful. I'm surprised that's the first one it's recorded this entire stream. I don't think I've ever played Warframe. Is that a shooter? Is that the game I'm thinking of? If so, that explains why I never played it, because I'm not usually huge with shooters. Achievement! Island Explorer. I didn't get an achievement for all the speed traps and stuff. But, I will get an achievement for the boards. Achievement! Gotta smash them all! Now I feel like playing Pokemon, too. Alright, let's go to... Wait, skill streak. Hold on. Medium. 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 Medium! Alright, so it doesn't really matter. I was gonna say, Warframe is a shooter, but very unlike other shooters. See, usually, like, first-person shooters... Not counting, like, Far Cry and Borderlands and stuff like that, where it's, like, a first-person shooter, but it's, like, an RPG kind of shooter. Usually, I can't get into shooters, like, hardcore shooters, Call of Duty, Battlefield, things like that. Only one I've ever really been able to get super into was... And I say super into as in I've played it. But even then, I still don't really play it too much, is Counter-Strike. But even then, me playing it is, like, once in a while. And I've been playing the new one. What is that? I'm blanking. Overwatch. Been playing that a little bit, but... Even that, it's like one of those where, yeah, it's fun, but I'm more of like a, god damn it, this is awful. See, it says smash 90 boards, but I don't know if there's only 90 boards or if I can miss a bunch and hope for the best. I'm just gonna go for it. It's like, has more of an MMORPG feel. It's like Assassin's Creed meets Ratchet and Clank. Now I'm trying to picture what the hell you could mean by that. Because that sounds very interesting. That sounds like a very interesting combination. Okay, I'm just going for it because I don't... They're not on the map. I would assume they would be on the map if I had to hit all of them. Like, they'd be marked. Not that it's like, oh, well, you missed one in the random middle part of the path, so. It's like, insane mobility. I knew I wasn't gonna do that. I was 9 boards short. So, note to self, don't, like, back up and try to hit all those things. And stupid gunplay that looks like Ratchet and Clank. Alright. Might have to try that at some point. I think I've heard things about it, but I think... Now that I'm thinking about it, I've heard that it wasn't that good, but I've heard that from the friend that I was talking about earlier that I usually disagree with his taste in games anyway. So, that could be why I've never tried it, because I listened to him. Four abilities like in Overwatch. Alright. Yeah, I might have to try it. But yeah, I think it was my one friend that has, like, completely different taste in games than me. He probably said, oh, yeah, it's not that great. And then I was like, oh, well, I'm not gonna try it then. You know, because I should definitely listen to his taste in games. Most of the game is PvE. Hey, great. Because when other players come into it, that's when I just am absolutely awful. There's a reason why when I've been playing Overwatch, I've been mostly playing against bots so I can actually get good before I start playing versus against. Like, versus against, yes. That's what I wanted to say there. Before I play against other people, I've been like, I could play against other people, but let's go bots. So you do not play against others if you don't want to. The game is really chill. It sounds like it. It actually sounds not too bad. Oh, complete your first Storm Island bucket list. I was so confused as to what I just got. Oh, the one that I have 10% towards is the Porsche bucket list. That's the one that confused me. I was like, I thought I already had one of these done in the Storm Island. Nope, I didn't. And I'm getting experience. I need to get to that level 150. Get to that level 150 so I can do stuff. How long have I been doing that? 2 hours of Forza. That's... May post a link to post to show the overall feel of the game. I don't know. Do I have... I think I have links disabled and I don't remember how to enable them again. How do I do that? Made a good trailer not too long ago. I'll probably just have to look it up. That was for a new character. But yeah, I definitely will have to look it up at some point. What am I doing? Racing to the destination? I just started this bucket list item completely unaware of what I was actually doing. Like, oh, I need to do a bucket list item. What am I doing? Fuck if I know. Send private message. That works. That works, just because... tree. I was coming. I don't think I'm gonna win this one. I am not gonna win this one. Mostly because I had no idea what I was doing. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Yep, that was not going. Yeah, that was not happening. Cool. I'll have to look that up. Or, not look it up. You gave me the link. I'll have to watch it. But I think... What I'm going to do, I think... I think I'm done with Forza for now. It's one of those games, right when I started, it was like, yeah, I'm gonna do Forza, I'm gonna make so much progress, and then as soon as I started, it's like, yeah, I don't know if I want to do this anymore. So, I think that's good. I mean, I got through two events, got most of the freaking, well, got all the collectibles in Storm Island, so I don't have to worry about those anymore. And did a bucket list item, so it's way more progress than I expected to make. So I think what I'm going to do is I switch back to this one. I am going to take a break. Just a short break. I mean, I still have liquid, but should probably fill that up. I take a short break, come back, do some Undertale. Forgot what I said I was going to do. Already. So, do that. So, I guess I will be...